As for any tools or software, before to use it, you need to learn it. It's why I really advise you to take a look at this entire tutorial video to know how Shadit is working before to use it. Well, open Shadit. You have three tabs on the top, Shader, Tools and Info, and here sub-tab with different category of material. At first, we need a scene to work with, so we go to Tools, and here I give you three scenes. The two first one are for look div, and third one, which is a studio lighting scene, which is really great for clear render of your asset, and of course, working with Shadit as a template. With one click, you will import in your scene, but here we want to open it with all the render settings. So right click, open the scene. Okay. I also advise you to go to Windows, UI Elements, and be sure to have the command line open. This way, you will have here feedback and helps for Shadit. Don't care about error red message. It's nothing important, okay? That will not avoid Shadit to work. Just care about yellow warning message that will give you some help and info about what you're doing wrong with Shadit. Okay, so now we need Arnold. So launch a render. And I will put the render view here. Perfect. I advise you to go to render, save your thread, and check for two or three thread saving to keep some power for Maya and Shadit to work correctly. Here we have our scene. Now I can apply shader. So we go to shader. For that, I select one mesh or multiple mesh, and we will apply it the paint metal STBY, for example. Okay, apply, render, and boom, it's working. So what's the idea of Shadit? The idea of Shadit is in the first time to give you a library of Arnold material pre-made for you, or you just have to apply. Then in second time, the ability to edit them. With Shadit, you don't edit shader with HyperShade or an attribute editor because the shaders are too complex. Okay, you see, this is a graph for this shader, which is quite too complex for you to understand and edit here. It's why I create a specific panel where the main parameter you need to edit. For that, it's really simple. You need to select a mesh and click on Edit Shader to open the edit panel of this shader. For example, if I have no mesh selected and I click here, nothing happened, and you will see a warning message here. You should select one mesh. Okay. For like that, you will have some two tips that will help you in Shadit if you made some mistake. So you always need to have the mesh with the shader you want to edit selected. For example, here, if I create another one, a yellow one, you saw I want to edit the black one, I select it, open. You will see here on the title menu the shader you are editing or the yellow one here. Okay, so I will come here and go back to the black. Now you just have to come here and edit your shader directly on your render on the fly. The first parameter is the scaling. Scaling to fit the material scale to the object. You see here we have quite large scale detail. If I change, for example, to 1, you see it's even bigger. So here, 1, we have a big, large scale detail. And if I increase the detail of the texture, let's say 8, we have something quite better. So a bit too much, we go to 5 maybe. Yes, good. Then noise, which will add noise to the surface. So here is quite too much, but it's just to show you. And with global scale, I can edit. The global scale affects all the parameters here, as you can see. So I want something like that, you know, to disturb a bit the specula. And here the value is quite too much, just a bit, maybe too much too. Okay. Then some bump. Same here, too strong. If you want, for example, to come back to the default value, you have this little button up, which will reset each parameter to the default value, which is the best in most of cases. Okay, so here you see a fine bump, which is better with default value. For the color, I will prefer to use a yellow one. That will be easier for us to understand. The color, it's a bit particular. As you can see, there is not just and only a color slot. There are also a U and SAT at first. Why I do that? Because we use texture here in your shader. Okay, texture with nice real texture, so with nice realistic color variation on the texture. If you override the color of this texture with a color, that will fill the texture with this color and you will lose the realistic aspect. Okay, it's why it's better to use a U saturation than override the color of a texture to keep the realistic variation of the texture. Okay, so here it's already set, but we can test if I put right here. So the texture, the base texture is like that. So if I want, for example, something more, I don't know, let's say green, I will prefer to first set my saturation with variation here to a green. I also have the saturation here. And after, why not come here and say I want something more like that. Okay, it's the way it's working for that. And the last one is a break. Okay, so I come back to some default value. Here the break is 2-0, and if I, you know, increase the break, in fact that breaks the variation in the diffuse, adding, you saw, some spot like that. And here you have something clean and unified, and here something a bit more break. So it's interesting to have a bit of break, but not too much. It depends of the effect you want. So just a bit for something more realistic. Okay, then really simple, the specular intensity, if you want more or less, and a roughness. But of course, when you, for example, you slide a roughness here in Shadit, is more complex than just the slider in Arnold standard surfaces, because here it's driven by many maps, layering, etc. So here it's just a slider, but in fact, as you see here, the reflection is more complex because it's driven by fingerprint maps and different kind of complex map to have this kind of nice realistic look and not just a simple shader. Okay, so I like this yellow shader. It's great, so why not to apply it everywhere? Yes, and we will work with this guy. So as you see, in fact, in the edit panel on the top, same thing, you have different tabs with different options, of course. So the basics we saw here, the scratch, which is all rebuild anew in Shadit 2.0 with a lot more control, because scratches are really important for metal, dirt, rust, dust, and decals. Okay, so let's play with. I will just select an area like this and zoom in. The first one is edge rear. Scratches will appear on the edges, harder edges of your model. Of course, like all value, be really subtle with if you want a realistic look. In fact, you saw here is too much. Just be really, really subtle with and find the right value. The idea of shade it is also to don't have a substance-like look, but something more subtle. For the other setting, I will put this to zero. Like that, we will isolate each one to understand. The fine one, which are some little spots of scratch that will appear on your model, and you can control them. The S is for scaling, so same thing than global scale. When you go to one, you have big scale, and the more you increase, the more fine you will have. Okay. The idea with the scratch system is to try to place the scratch the where you want. Okay. For example, here I found a nice scaling, and after you can, for example, rotate here and move on X. So here maybe you saw X and Y axis. With this, you can place the scratches on interesting area. So the idea is not to control each one, okay? It is to add a variation and a random proposition to you, and this random proposition will be great, okay, in most of case, because that will appear in some place and that will be interesting. For example, I saw, okay, it's not too bad here. Maybe if I do that, I have more air. Just play with, in fact. Okay, this one is quite more interesting, and it's okay for me. If I do that, I have this one here, which is great. No. Okay, you just play with like that on your model. No, yeah, just some like that. Then you have the medium one, which is the same idea, but with bigger scratches effect, as you can see. Yes, okay. And the last one are more like scratches this way. Great. Okay. So if you activate everything, that's quite too much scratches. So choose the effect you want and don't add too much scratches to your scene. So let's keep this one for the example. This one may be a more subtle. Yes. After that, you have ici some control for the under metal, like intensity, roughness. So if I increase the roughness, I will keep everything, or something shiner. And you also have a bump, a little layering bump effect, you know, as a paint shader, you can see here there is some bump. If I put the bump to zero, we lose this effect. And it's better with, let's see, here there is a bump effect, so I can choose. Okay. So intensity is too strong. Okay, some interesting things happen everywhere. Well, so now I am happy with my scratches, but there is always too much. For that, we will use a mask, the new Paint Mask feature. How it works? You have a little help icon here that will open you a note with the rules to respect in order that the mask works as expected. There can only be one mesh with one paint mask by shader. This means I can create a paint mask here for this mesh, and for this mesh. Okay, only one paint mask for all this yellow shader. Which means if I need to identify where I want to use a paint mask. I don't want, for example, for on this mesh, so I will not select this mesh. I want for this one, this three mesh. So what I advise you to do is to select the mesh you want and combine them. It is the only way to have Shadit working on different parts. The first time you will create a paint mask, there will be a process task, so just wait some second. Painting doesn't update on real time in Arnold Render View, so you need to update the full scene with Ctrl U. Okay, we will see that. Yes, and the paint mask should be created before assign a decals. We will so later. Okay, so some rules to respect, as for any tools. Everything is okay. I will pause Arnold. Come here in the viewport. Be sure to have the texture here well activated. Otherwise, you will not have a texture on the viewport, of course. And you can now hit the paint mask button. Wait for some second, and boom, that happened. You have a paint mask window that appear, and now you will paint the area you want to hide the scratches effect. Really simple, as any brush, a size, some presets, and a color. In white, it's where you want everything appear. For now, it's full white, so nothing will change. And in black, we will paint in black, okay? And that will hide, of course, where repainting. So I paint in viewport. So no need to have a real-time feedback. You can see here with the render, okay? So here, I don't want to erase it, so okay. I will paint in black. I want to erase some area, like in the middle here, there is too much. Okay, in this area, maybe there is too much. I will put something stronger. Yes, here, there is too much. Let's say here, it's not an area. Okay. Now, let's render that. Wait for a second. Arnold will update the scene, I think. Oh no. Okay, so it seems Arnold updates the scene for us. And yes, nice. I can continue to paint. For here, for example. You saw, of course, the viewport lag if you keep Arnold render. So Arnold will update, but I advise you to stop Arnold and paint first. For example, here. Then each render. Okay. And now, once I'm happy with my painting, I close the window and that will come back here in the viewport to the right shader. Okay, now let's play with dirt, rust and dust. So the dirt, I will go intensity at maximum. Of course, the dirt is working on occlude area, as you can see here. You have a spread. For this, you can change also the color, but I will keep it black. and here control the intensity, which is also the opacity. So here too strong, I want something really just a bit of dirt. Here not too much. Okay. Then we have the rust, same thing, intensity. So here nothing will happen because we need to play with the spread. You can change the rust color. So here is a spread, as you can see, to propagate from occlude area. And here you have the soft that will fill your object with a little soft rust effect. You saw? Okay. So which is great is to do that and play with intensity. Same thing to have a not too strong rust effect. Okay, so I don't want rust. And the dust. We made the dust effect here. I want something with more color. Yes, lighter. And always with intensity. Can I adjust the dust effect? And here my dirt effect. And the last tab, the decals. So for decals, you need to load a PNG image with transparency. Okay. Then select a mesh you want to decals, this one. I will create decals. A decals one, for example, this one in PNG. Up, everything is updated here. Okay, and you have a manipulator here that will project in front of your camera view. Okay, so if I want, for example, to put it on the top, I advise you to go to perspective and focus with your camera on the top. Okay, so as you can see, that plug it. Depending of the view of your camera. Then you place and you have here a little cross. You can select it to have more manipulator control, like for example, rotation. Yes. Okay. And once it's done, you exit. And you have your decals. So this is just for the basics, okay? I will make a more in-depth with a project tutorial later. But for now, you have all the base for use Shaded 2.0.